warning. You behave yourself, or they won't stop at cutting your hair next time. And I don't think I'd lift a finger to help you.
I can fight my own battles, Morris.
Make a pretty good story, I reckon. You and the old man growing dope on the premises. I even reckon his wife will believe me after I tell her about the other business. Don't you? Now, why don't you put that down and be nice, like I said. We haven't got much time.
Don't panic. There's no one in the corridor. What are you up to?
I'm making money, lots of it.
Yeah, me too. Nev bought the stuffing. I reckon I ought to clear 20 bucks by the time I sell this.
20 bucks, eh?
What does that say? I killed once. 50,000 or I'll kill you. I wait orders? You're kidding.
Am I?
50,000's a fair bit, isn't it?
Why not? Reckon we can trust your mate Neville to do the outside work for us?
All the way. As long as he gets his cut, of course. 10%.
Fair enough.
Boy, having that money waiting for me is going to make life a lot sweeter in here. God, I knew you onto something, but I didn't know it was this big.
As long as that Neville doesn't stuff it up for us.
Nev? Nah. He knows I got enough on him to put him inside. And that's one place he's steering clear of. He done the dirty on a mate.
Nice company you keep, Lou.
Wasn't Nev's fault. He was forced into it.
Oh, yeah, all right.
He'll play it right. Cool, he's got a hell of a lot more to lose than we have if he tries shooting through with that money.
Yep. We've got nothing to lose.
Oh, come on, Marlene, the bell's gone and Mr. Proctor's made some wonderful salmon patties for dinner.
Yeah, I know. I lost my appetite.
Oh, I hope you're not coming down with anything.
Yeah, screaming Abies.
I better go and get Sister.
Hey, Pigs. I'm not sick, all right?
But you just said that you were coming down with something.
Yeah, that just means I'm really scared.
Why?
Because Lou and Francis racked off with all my money and now I've got nothing left to pay me book out with.
Oh, it's bad enough being locked up in here without being locked up with thieves.
Yeah, well, anyway, I reckon there's going to be murder done tomorrow morning and I can't say I blame anybody.
Well, tell Myra about it. She'll get your money back and fix those two.
Nah, this is one I've got to look after myself.
No, I'll help you. But come on, we'll feel better after we've had something to eat.
Hey, maybe you can help. You're an ace pickpocket, aren't you?
Mm-hmm.
Well, Lou's bound to be carrying the money on her.
Oh, gosh, when... I don't know.
Hey, guess what?
Back off.
I've got this great idea to get our money back.
Whoopee.
Pix is going to pick Lou's...
Look, I don't want to know, okay? Will you get out?
Look, we've got to do something about it, really.
Oh, will you bugger off and leave me alone? We'll get it back, okay? But later.
Yeah, right.
Hi, Meg. Hope I haven't kept you waiting too long.
I got held up down in D Block. Whoops, I guess I should watch how I say things around here. That's better. Now, are you ready to go tackle some of Joe's special of the day?
Well, actually, I've just written you a note. Anne is coming to spend the night with me.
Oh, no, you don't. I'm not going to let you back out of this dinner.
Well, I can't very well leave her to just
get
her
own. Yes, you can, and Anne would be the first one to agree with me.
All right. So can I say I have changed my mind?
Yes, you can. You can shut yourself away for as long as you like. But sooner or later, you're going to have to come to terms with what's happened. And sooner it'll be a lot easier on yourself and everyone else. Look, I'm not being heartless. It's just you can't hide yourself away and stop living.
Hello, you two. Oh, you should have stayed here for dinner tonight. Ray has really outdone himself.
Yeah, well, he said he'd make me something special for lunch tomorrow.
Well, you're certainly in the good books, aren't you?
Actually, I think he's after my body.
Oh, lucky you. Oh, I'm glad I've caught you together. That new woman, Davies, she's still refusing to eat. Perhaps you could have a word with her tomorrow, Philip. It could help.
Yes, of course.
Well, it won't be easy. We've had cases like this before.
You know, I think she's just pining away for a husband, poor thing. And, of course, the women are teasing her about missing out on the comforts of home. I mean, you know what they
are. Yes, well, they could be right. I mean, you can't just bring a healthy physical relationship to a full stop without some sort of mental anguish.
Oh, for heaven's sake. Why is it that everything that happens in this place always comes down to sex? And from what I've heard, that isn't Davy's trouble.
No, but it might be mine soon. Norm is threatening to trade me in for a hot water bottle.
Oh, for God's sake.
Oh, Meg, it's just a joke. Norm's always saying it. I wouldn't be laughing about it if I thought he meant it.
I'm sorry, Joyce. I'm just tending to overact a bit lately. All work and no play is no good for me.
You're right.
As a matter of fact, I think a night on the town might just be the answer.
Good. Night, Joyce, and hey, don't steal Ray away from me while I'm gone, okay?
Go on. Have a good time. Night.
Oh, you feel like a thrashing?
Not tonight, you won't.
Hold it, everybody. Just make an happy shopping list. If you're short on goodies, just come to good old Luha and she'll fix you up. Only got booze and fags at the moment.
Okay. How'd you get those in?
It's none of your business, is it?
It is my business if the freak's in on it.
Well, she ain't.
What about you, Warren?
Got a nice line in shampoos coming in next week.
Yeah, Lou, giving it away, are you?
Cash up front. Little birdie tells me you're broke, Warren.
Marlene?
Well, I am just till tomorrow. I'm not sure how much money I've got left over yet.
Oh, it's all right, Marlene. I have some spare shampoo. You can have one of mine.
Thanks, Pix.
Lucky, Warren. What about the girl she owes money to? What are they supposed to buy stuff with?
Okay. Yeah, fine. Look, I'm sick and tired of the way people never trust people in this place. I'm going myself.
Oh, just a minute, Marlene. I'll come with you.
Oh bloody people, get off me, you mole. I'm the one that got knocked down.
Yeah, well, you deserve knocking down.
Oh, shut up.
You? She didn't have the money. She just had this.
What's the good of that to me?
Oh, they really are.
I spoke to you, Adams, and I expected.
Cheer up. You could always say the judges changed their minds and all the horses lost.
Well, yeah, they'd really believe that too, Pix.
Oh, well, maybe Bobby will come up with something. Stop worrying. It'd be awful to get wrinkles at your age. Now, which one would you like? That one or that one?